So I'm Natalia Stiblina. I'm from Ukraine, Vasilevsko-Donetsk National University, which is situated in Vinnytsia, because actually there are two Donetsk National Universities. One is Donetsk, which is now occupied, and another one moved to Vinnytsia. So in my presentation, I will try to compare speeches of Belarusian President Lukashenko and Ukrainian presidents, and to speculate about similarities or differences of the political regimes of both countries. So the collapse of the USSR gave for scholars a variety of different political regimes, which can be easily defined. The independent states predominantly call themselves democracies, have parliaments and some other institutions which are important for a democratic state, hold elections and etc. However, in many cases we just can constitute an existence of just imitative democracy, which is used for covering frequent civil and political freedom violations, corruption and other abuses. Among all these examples, Belarusian and Ukrainian cases seem to be interesting ones. Having a similar past geographical position between Russia and the West, Belarus has been demonstrating clear intentions towards authorization of its political regime since mid-90s and has not free status since 1996 in Freedom House reports. Whereas Ukraine has been situated somewhere in the middle, not authoritative regime nor democratic ones. In scientific discourse, both regimes hasn't been obtained constant definition. Belarusian one is called just a paradox or a phenomenon or Lukashenkism, and sometimes we can meet both authoritative state or emerging democracy and so on and so forth. As for Ukraine, we also see democracy, but usually scientists just specify and add some characteristics like rhetorical or transitive or imitative or cynical and so on. So we can say that it is important to seek some additional characteristic for both regimes and try to define them more clearly. My main hypothesis that we can find some peculiarities of political regime in political text. So political regime is a kind of a mirror for a political regime, and there are some indicators in the text which may be a signal for regime specifics. So for my research, I used speeches of Ukrainian presidents Yushchenko, Yanukovych and Poroshenko, and speeches of Belarusian president. I collected them via internet archive and analyzed with Python program. I used module Ray and regular expressions. It is interesting that discovering Lukashenko's speeches, I found that sometimes some of his speeches just disappear from his official site. For instance, in April 2014, there were not speeches at all, and they all were deleted. If we speak about, for instance, December 2015, we also have some gaps here, like, I don't know, memory gaps, because For instance, here we don't have Lukashenko's speeches on the 9th of May, or a speech or his speech during the Independence Day. So sometimes this speech is just deleted, and so I moved back in the time with the help of this web archive in order to collect all his speeches. As for Ukrainian case, we have another problem because usually in Ukraine the president's team usually remove all speeches and all texts of the protester. So web archive is also was useful for me, and additionally some speeches of Ukrainian presidents may be found in an official newspaper, Volos Ukraine. As for Yanukovych and Poroshenko, I also found several gaps. For instance, there were some speeches during this the beginning of 2014 during shootings at Maidan and all these events. And as for Poroshenko, during Azov crisis also several speeches were deleted, and I used other sources just to find these speeches. As for the analysis to approve my research hypothesis, I supposed that for authoritative regime some additional characteristics may be added. Firstly, intensity of a president's speech with low number of president's appearances for authoritative regime and high number of for more democratic one. And thus, the authoritative regime may be characterized as more closed and more stable on the communicative level, with no need for constant communication with between a president and different political groups, society, and so on. Genders and subgenres are also the matter. For the authoritative regime with more stable communication, traditional forms may be used, speeches, appeals, statements, etc. However, special occasions and hot events, which are usually emerge in the reality of more dynamic regime, may need new forms of expression, especially in the digital times. Additionally, formats and occasions may also show the difference between close and stable regimes, and varied geography and audiences should also define more democratic regime. To study all the texts, several Python programs were designed. I used, as I said, I used Module Rare, and in some cases I looked for prepositions or special expressions which defined audience format or occasion of a speech. This approach helped me to discover a political text written on several languages, for instance, on Ukrainian and Russian, and however, it is also possible to add other languages as well, for instance, Belarusian. This is an example of a program which analyzes formats of used by the president. So, as for finding, authoritative regime is definitely has no need to in intense communication and deep engagement of a president. In Ukraine, a president shows up 40 or 50 times with special appeals to people, parties, countries, institutions. However, in Belarus, we may observe approximately 15 speeches per year. Here, the case of Belarus correlates with, for instance, Kazakhstan. Nazarbayev is also not as active as public speeches. As for genders, we don't observe such a clear distinction. For instance, both Yushchenko and Poroshenko used more genders and subgenres of speeches, whereas Yanukovych and Lukashenko didn't. However, maybe it would be more appropriate to divide 15 years of Lukashenko presidency, for my research, into three comparable periods, because Ukrainian presidents have for 5 years to experience explore different speech genres. Quite similar picture we see with their occasions. Again, Lukashenko and Yanukovych used more traditional occasions for their speeches. They preferred stable and planned communication. However, the difference between them may be seen in their reasons for celebrations or commemorations. Lukashenko's occasions are more connected with the Soviet past, commemorations of Afghanistan, for instance, Afghanistan veterans, or 9th of May, and so on. However, Yanukovych, along with this, with his pro-Russian orientation, had to continue some traditions of his predecessor. His speeches were about Holodomor, Kruty, heroes, and etc. One more point, so-called calendar occasions of Ukrainian president contained also refers to international agenda. For instance, there were speeches about the Day of Student, Tuberculosis Day, and so on and so forth. However, Lukashenko's speeches were about internal or historical events. In the speeches of Ukrainian presidents, we also see larger variety of mentioned formats. Lukashenko preferred seminars, congresses, conferences, meetings, just more traditional formats. However, his colleagues presented their speeches within memory evenings, consultations, special presidential hearings, roundtables. Different formats mean different ways of communication with public in some cases, for instance, consultations of round tables, not only president speaking, but other speakers as well. This leads us to the comparison of audiences, which were mentioned in president's speeches. As we see, Yushchenko and Poroshenko defined their audiences much more often, and all the Ukrainian presidents appealed to more different audiences categories than Lukashenko did. And the last point, geography, shows us different preferences of the presidents. Lukashenko appealed to the Commonwealth countries more often, whereas only a few European countries were mentioned. Usually, Lukashenko doesn't specify the certain country and use Europe. As for what does it mean for political communication in other fields, for instance, in political news? Here we also can see that low intensity of political communication in Belarus may be additionally observed with the low constant attention towards other political actors and towards Lukashenko. For instance, percent of news lines mentioned a president on Belopan was about 5%, and if we speak about Ukrainian presidents, 10%, or even if we speak about Yanukovych, 23. Also, we have in Belarus the high number of unique political subjects mentioned in headlines, and this correlates with low number of political subjects mentioned in news headlines. Only Poroshenko case in Poroshenko presidency we have another picture. Belarusian and Ukrainian cases show us that presidents' public appeals are important for more open, active, diverse political communication. With low popularity of presidential speeches as a genre in digital times, societies in both democratic and authoritative countries may not benefit from this. And of course, we should continue to monitor these processes to discover their future transformations, and the formal analysis of the president's speeches shows a certain characteristic of political texts which may be used for a political regime's differentiation. There are different approaches towards intensity of speeches where authoritative leaders are more passive. However, we may suppose that there are authoritative regimes where this indicator may differ, for instance, Russian one. Additionally, authoritative regime with its more stable, predictable political communication provide us with more common genders, occasions, and formats of events. Thank you for your attention.